This SAP2000 tutorial will show how easy it is to install and manage CSI's web-activated software licenses. The license controls where and how you can run the software. Although this tutorial deals with SAP2000 license activation, the process is similar for most of CSI's other products, including ETABS and SAFE. There are two types of licenses: Standalone and Network. If you have purchased a standalone license, the software is locked to a specific computer. The software may be moved to another computer, but this requires a deactivation. A network license allows the software to be accessed anywhere on a network. If a single network license has been purchased, one copy of the program may be run anywhere on the network at a given time. The more network licenses purchased, the more copies of the program that may be run simultaneously. We will start by activating a license for a standalone program. Once you have purchased your software, you will receive an email from the CSI licensing department that looks something like this. This email indicates that your software has a web-activated license. It does not require any USB locking device. This email contains a number of important items. First, it allows us to download the installation wizard. We will show how this works in a moment. It also contains the all-important activation key. This is the key that unlocks the software. This is a very important code. Save the email in a safe spot, and you might also copy the key and place it in a text file for safekeeping. Under the product details, the version of the software licensed is displayed. In this case, it is a SAP2000 Plus. Note that standalone is also indicated. Also note the quantity associated with the license and the duration of the license. Licenses may be updated at no cost using the standalone key. Now we will install the CSI installation wizard by clicking on the link. In order to install the software, you will need to have an active internet connection. With the wizard running, we select the first option, Install CSI Software. In addition to installing the software for the first time, the wizard may be used to update already installed versions. We now click Next. On the next page, we select our product. In this case, SAP2000. Item 2 is where we differentiate between installing a standalone license and a network license. We are currently doing a standalone, so we select this option and enter the activation key from the email we received. We then click Next. We will download the latest installation. This may be downloaded to any directory on your computer, such as a temp directory. With the download complete, we will now install the program. Follow the installation instructions. And the program will notify you that it has been installed and that the license for a standalone plus is activated. SAP2000 can now be run. If we wish to move the standalone version of SAP 2000 to a different computer, we can do so using the standalone key program found in the CSI licensing folder under the program folder. We suggest that you also review the standalone key PDF for additional information. Double-clicking to start the standalone key program, note that the program is alerting us to the fact that our license will be deactivated, which needs to occur in order to move the license to another computer. We get confirmation that the standalone has been deactivated, and then our activation key is displayed so that we can license the software on another computer. Again, it is important to copy this key to a safe spot. You may then reinstall the software on another computer using the procedure just described, reusing the activation key that you have securely stored. Next, we will show a network license activation. If you purchased a network license, you will receive an email from CSI that looks very similar to the one sent for the standalone license. Note that there are two specific installation discussions. The first deals with activating the license on the license server. This is the computer that will be serving the license over the network to the various workstations. The license server tracks the usage of SAP 2000 over the network and limits the number of computers that can simultaneously run the software to the number of licenses purchased. The second set of instructions deals with installing the software on the workstation. This is similar to what was just done for the standalone installation, and thus will be skipped to save time. Note that the workstation installation needs to be performed on each computer when you wish to run the software. Like the standalone email, note that the network has an activation key. This key will be used during the license server installation. Under the product details, we see what software is licensed. In this case, the advanced version of SAP 2000 in network form. We also see that a total of 3 licenses have been purchased, which means that up to 3 copies may run simultaneously across the network. We will now install the license server by clicking on the link. On the installation wizard, we will use the second option to install the network license. The network license should be installed prior to installing any workstation software. We now click Next. Assuming that we are on the computer that will be used to serve the license, we select the Yes option and click Next. On the next page, we download the latest License Manager installation. And then follow the installation instructions. This is a two-part installation. The first installation installs the License Manager, which is the program that serves up the licenses. The second installation installs the utilities, a series of tools that help administer the licenses. We will click Yes, as we do want to activate a network license. Next, we copy in our activation key. Note, the program asks us how many of the 3 SAP 2000 Advanced licenses we will activate. And you will typically activate all of the available, which in this case is 3. The program now confirms that all 3 licenses are activated. If we had more than one activation key, we could enter them here by clicking Next. But we don't, so we can close the form. The license server installation is now complete. Returning to the wizard, we would use the first option to install the software on a workstation. Again, please note that a workstation install should only be done after the network license is installed. Although we are going to skip this step since it is similar to the standalone install, to do a workstation installation, we would select this option, and on the next page, select our software, and then select the second option in step 2. Note that for the workstation install, it does not ask for the activation key as it did for the standalone. The activation key is used when installing the network license server. Again, we will not complete this step since it is similar to a standalone install. Similar to the standalone key file that was used to manage the standalone license, there are 2 programs helpful for managing the network licenses. These are NetKey and WLMAdmin, which are found in the Sentinel Utilities folder under Computers and Structures. The Windows License Manager Administrator file allows us to see what licenses are being used. Double-clicking on this file, we expand the subnet node, which is where our license server resides, and then expand the server node. We see that this computer is serving SAP2000 Advanced with a total of 3 licenses. It also shows that none are currently being used. The other program, NetKey, allows for the activation and deactivation of licenses. For example's sake, let's say we wish to switch from 3 to 2 active network licenses. We start by deactivating the licenses, and we get confirmation that the licenses are deactivated. Double-clicking on the NetKey program again, but this time selecting the Activate option, we enter our network activation key. But this time, activate only 2 of the licenses. Now we get confirmation that 2 licenses are indeed activated. This completes this tutorial on installing and managing web-activated software licenses.